if you got the money. I think it would be funny, uh-oh, to take your girl, spend a bit of your cash for me. Cos then she might be happy, no longer lonely, uh-oh. And I could take her out the next day for pretty much free. And all the boys, they go da-dee-doo-da-da-dee-da-doo-da, dum-dum-de-de-dum-dum.
It all started when I was at school. See, I always had something. I always knew that I had something to offer the school footy team. When we won the cup and the league in the same season for the first time since 78, with me banging in the goals like it was second nature, the head teacher made the whole school, kids and teachers, give me a standing ovation. It weren't long before the professional league clubs were scouting around. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm an Amers boy, through and through. But when blues come calling, you don't say no. My first day at the club, I was well nervous. In the car parks, you can see them all lined up. Ferraris, BMW, Porsches, Aston Martin. The days of growing up in my house with hand-me-downs where I'd have to wear my brother's clothes were over. It took me a while to find my swing. A few months in the reserves, I couldn't even get near the ball, not even a whiff of it. Gaffer told me off a couple of times, told me to relax, play my game. Don't let the opposition play me. But I knew I had until the next game with Liverpool reserves to turn it round. No way was I going to walk in at Morrison's on the Monday, ready to start work as a shelf stacker. It weren't until the 72nd minute when it happened, when my whole life changed forever. My man, Ashley Thomas, was coming through on the left and I was using everything inside to keep up with him. But if I got too fast, I'd be caught offside, so I had to time it. I had to be careful. Ashley could be a greedy player at times, but God bless him though. Because he did as he was told for once. He crossed it over so sweet. It was like making a rainbow as he crossed. It was beautiful. I was exactly where I needed to be. And the ball flew off my head as I smashed it into the top right-hand corner of the goal. The next day, the papers were making me out to be a bright star of the future. Got a blinding agent and he set up the sweetest deal for me. I had more money in my pocket than I knew what to do with. I bought a house for my mum and dad. I saw that my brothers and my sisters were right, but the girls, oh man. Skirts so short you don't know where to look. Don't get me wrong, I'm no amateur. I went to have a few girls on the estate, but these girls, something else, I ain't lying. You know what you got to do, but don't know where to start. But it got to the point now where the other lads are thinking I might be a bit light on my feet unless I make my move. I'm just biding time, that's all. I know when I'm ready. And I am ready. I feel good. Like I'm the best ever. I'm primed, ripe and ready. Just like that girl had better be ready. Because it is time. Time for me, Rod Tyler, to unleash.
But it doesn't make sense.
Of course it makes sense. You are just choosing not to think. You want sugar in yours?
No, Ty. Look, they made a mistake, a blinding mistake, Max.
No, they didn't.
Why can't they just put their hands up?
He's right there, Sean, if you could be bothered to look.
I grew up watching them every bank holiday. They made a mistake, it's no big deal.
Only if they made one, but it wasn't a mistake.
All right, then, explain it to me.
All right, are you standing comfortably?
Get on with it, Max.
Then I shall begin. Right, you and me in this room, which is in this police station is on this street is in this borough, this borough is in this city is in this country is in this continent. All right, I will cut to the chase.
Thank you.
We all exist in this universe. This one great big universe, correct?
If you say so.
And I do. Now, there is a theory going around that as well as this universe, there are millions and millions of other universes.
I think you've been watching too much Star Trek, Max.
Think of any decision you've ever made. Do I buy chicken for dinner tonight, or do I buy a pizza? Do I marry Heather Palmer or Sandy Connell? Do I stay in uniform or be a detective? See where I'm going?
Insane.
As you choose to go one way, a brand new universe is created that shows you're going the other way. I married Heather, had three girls, but somewhere out there is me shacked up with Sandy Connell. That's a fact. Look it up. Go online.
It's not a fact. It's a theory.
So let's imagine the world of fiction operates the same as us. They have millions of other universes like us. Agree?
Yeah.
So that means somewhere out there, there is a universe that exists with George Lazenby as James Bond.
Right.
So, in George Lazenby's universe as James Bond, the events of You Only Live Twice never happened. In his universe as James Bond, he went straight from Thunderball to On Her Majesty's Secret Service.
But Sean Connery was James Bond in Thunderball.
It doesn't matter.
Of course it matters.
You are not listening.
I am listening to every word, mate.
Universes, Sean, millions of them. Lazenby's universe, he's James Bond doing everything Connery was doing in Dr. No, From Russia With Love and Thunderball, but skipping over You Only Live Twice and going straight to Her Majesty's Secret Service. Prosecution rests.
I can't argue with you. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about.
So, what do you have for me today, young man?
Bleeding carnage is what? My march a hotel in town last night. The Blues finest were larging it up in the bar, celebrating their 2-0 win over Norwich. Bunch of Norwich fans were also there.
What, they didn't go home?
Well, they were in London. They wanted to make a weekend of it. A few drinks later, both sides are getting well into it. Your Blues this, your Canaries that. Wasn't long before it blew up into a mini riot. Tables flipped over, glasses smashed, the whole bar looked like a bomb site.
Right, and the reason why we are being called into this?
One of the barmen got stabbed in the face with a beer bottle.
Nasty.
Yeah, he's all right, but it was a bad cut. He's going to be scarred for the rest of his life.
So, who's the lucky one who did it then?
Well, this is where the fun begins. There were well over a dozen people in that bar and no one saw a thing. The barman tried to stop the fight, and before you ask, he has no idea who stabbed him. So, either no one saw anything...
And if you believe that...
Or our lot are covering up for one of theirs, and the Norwich boys are doing the same.
Any other witnesses?
Well, there were some girls hanging around, according to the barman. About 3 or 4, he reckons. And the Blues players were taking turns and chatting them up. Always in there on match days, you know the type, wannabe wags. Skirts as short as belts, trying to land themselves a Premier League boyfriend.
Has anyone taken their statements yet?
That, Max, is our cue.
Right then, so who's first?
Helen Cottle, age 18. She's in interview room 3.
OK then, let's go.
Lead on, sir.
It was bloody Kelly's fault.
Kelly?
My mate.
Who's Kelly, Helen?
Kelly Arnett, one of the other girls at the bar.
Right.
She's been after one for years, has Kelly.
After what?
A footballer. Younger the better. And she weren't interested in no championship player either. Not for Kelly. No way. It was Premier League or nothing. Those are the words. Kelly's words. Her words, not mine.
Right, okay, so...
Anyhow, she found out where they all hang out. You know, after a home game. Usually the three of us would go out every weekend, but Claire had the flu. I didn't want to go. I was up for a girls' night in. You know, X Factor, pizza, bottle of wine. But Kelly was desperate. She always is.
Right, so what happened, Helen?
It was because he looked like Orlando Bloom.
What?
My favourite actor in the whole wide world is Orlando Bloom. I just love him, ever since Pirates of the Caribbean.
I'm sorry, but what exactly does that have to do...
He looks like him. Rod Tyler. Don't you think?
I don't know. He does.
Hmm?
A little.
They could be twins. Kelly kept on saying to me, he's looking at ya, he's looking at ya.
And you like that?
Of course I did. I mean, he's unbelievably gorgeous. He was so nice, really friendly, at least at first. I knew what he had in mind. I knew he was chatting me up. Still liked it.
And,
you know...
Yeah, but is it relevant?
We were kissing. He was a really good kisser. He was nice and tender, stroking my leg up and down. He asked me if I wanted to go upstairs.
I think we're straying off the point a little here, Helen.
Sorry.
The trouble that broke out in the bar.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.